see some of my brothers over there, members of the DAV, etc. Yeah. And it brings back so many memories. Some might remember years ago, I think I was around 26, 27 years old. I used to be sitting right over there playing drums. Quinn, who about 8? Maybe 7, I don't know. But we remember those times. That was before I even became a pastor. So, St. John, you all had something to do with me going into ministry. Amen. But as I look around this congregation and see this community of believers. Now we have enough power in here. I'm talking Holy Ghost power. To stop Trump. To fix the whole country up right. Father, we thank you for blessing this congregation, for blessing your people as we come to hear word from you. From the book of Acts, chapter number 19. Acts 19. Beginning at verse number 1. We find these words recorded, and it happened while Paulus was at Corinth, that Paul, having passed through the upper regions, came to Ephesus. And finding some disciples, or should I say church people, he said to them, "Didn't you receive the Holy Ghost when you believe?" And they said to him, "We have not so much as heard that there is a Holy Ghost." And he said to them, "Well, into what were you baptized?" So they said, "Into St. John's baptism." No, John's baptism. Y'all hang with me now. Then Paul said, "John indeed baptized you with the baptism of repentance." That's all he did. Saying to the people that they should believe on him who would come after him, that is on Christ Jesus. When they heard this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And when Paul had laid hands on them, the Holy Ghost came upon them. And they spoke with tongues and prophesied. Now the men were about 12 in all. Now subject today or tonight is the Holy Ghost. Don't leave home without it. I'd like to speak tonight and introduce the psalm and present to others that last person in the Trinity. You know, we know something about Father God. It's Bible even alludes to the fact that physically, some people saw some parts of it. Then we know about Jesus, his son. And there's been a lot of singing tonight about Jesus. And how good he is. But Jesus is not here right now. But he has his Holy Spirit in. The word reveals him as the Holy Ghost, the Spirit of the Lord, and the Helper. He is the Comforter. the Spirit of truth. He convicts. He renews. And he can be grieved. He is omnipotent, which means he is all-powerful. He is omniscient, which means he is all-knowing. He is omnipresent. That means he's everywhere. He's in you and you and you. He's in me and he's in all of us. As long as we have been baptized in the name of Jesus and we believe him to be the Son. Christ said to in a promise in John chapter 14 that he was going to leave us a comforter, a helper. So we won't get scared. So we don't be beat down. So even if trouble comes, and it will come, amen, that we have someone we can go and talk to in the midnight hour. We can talk to him in the bedroom. We can even talk to him in the bathroom. Any room you get in, you can talk to him in your car. And he will hear you. For any students in here, you can talk to him in the classroom. And he will hear you. Oh, glory to God. Here's our helper. He was promised to come, but not only to come, but to give us power. Can the church say power? Holy Ghost power. Glory to God. In Psalm 62, it says that, this psalmist says that all power and power comes from God. It don't come from our money, our status. It don't come by you dressing up to come to church. But that power is in you. That power can keep help you to keep your mouth shut. Yeah. You know when you want to bless somebody out, all Christians don't do that. Some of them say, I laid my religion down just for a little while. I came by to tell you, you ain't got to lay no religion down when you have the Holy Ghost. You can be quiet and allow him to fight your battles. Amen. In a time of battle, shelter. In a time of storm. Thank you, Jesus. Now, as we talk about this third person in the Trinity, we can feel him sometimes. We just know he's there. There have been times when I have prayed and I didn't know which way to go. I felt like I was defeated sometimes. I believe I can get a witness in here. Yeah. And somehow or another, there was a calm. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Peace. Yeah. Be still. Yeah. He can calm seas. Yeah. So you know he can calm your little problem. Yeah. Peace. Yeah. Somebody right now needs some peace in your house. Peace. Somebody came to church because you don't have peace in your house. But the Holy Ghost is in you. You have peace. When nobody understands you, you have peace. He is a peace. Shalom. A God peace. When you don't have to understand, but he'll give the peace right in the midst of your storm. I'm reminded now in the book of Acts. Anybody here ever been sick before? I mean, really sick. Somebody sick in here right now? Doctor can't do you much good. pills don't help you pack. But you can call on the Holy Ghost, who lives. That's where he is. You know, people dress up the outside. But God doesn't care about the outside as much as he does the inside. When you get born again, you don't get born again on the outside, but on the inside. Oh, I got baptized in my Baptist roots when I was 12 years old. Somebody had told me at 12, you got to get baptized. I went up and gave the preacher my hand. You know, we used to have a mourner's bench back then. They don't even know what that is now. And whether you want to get on that bench or not, mama say, sit there till you get something. Can I get a witness? And we would sit there. And sit there. Finally, one Tuesday night, I felt something. And I went and gave the pastor my hand. I can remember some of the old songs they were singing. There were tears coming out of my eyes. So the following Sunday, they opened up the pool and they baptized all of the converts. And I had heard the song so much, when I came out the water, I looked at my hand, but my hand didn't look new. It looked the same way it was for a minute. My feet, they were just as flat as they were when I went in that pool. I said, now wait a minute, maybe I missed it. Later on I found out that it wasn't on the outside. That's why they something got a hold of me. And when it got a hold of me, it caused a change to come in my life, and it's been progressively going ever since. Yeah. Yeah. Glory to God. Yeah. So there was a man in the book of Acts chapter number 3. They said that he was a beggar. And he stayed there by the church and he continued to beg. Well, Paul came by, not Paul, but Peter came by during that time. You know, James, you know, they spent some time with Jesus. You know, Jesus told them, say, hey, don't you go nowhere till you get the Holy Ghost. You stay right here until that promise comes. Oh, y'all know about Pentecost. I don't have to go into that. But when Pentecost came, something happened to them. They became bold. Yeah. I like bold soldiers of the Lord. Yeah. People who don't mind praying for somebody. Yeah. People who don't mind laying hands on the sick and expect them to recover. Yeah. Good God Almighty. Yeah. Ooh. This man was big. He saw Peter coming. He said, give me some money. You know, folks going to church, they going to church, people got, think you got a certain attitude. Huh? Sometimes people come to the church to beg. Huh? I'm not talking about nobody, I'm just telling the truth. They'll come, and they'll come. But preacher, I'm one of those kind who believe in saying, silver and gold have I none. But such that I have, that I know, that's going to help you, I'm going to give it to you. In the name of Jesus, through this Holy Ghost that's in me, take up your bed and run. It says that as Peter now prayed for the man and laid hands on him, something happened. Man forgot all about the money. He forgot about what he had been doing all the time. Yeah. The Bible say he began to shout and praising God and leaping up and telling people all about what God had done for him. Do we have any witnesses like that? See, when the Holy Ghost comes on the inside of you, you can't keep it to yourself. You gotta tell somebody what the Lord has done for you. And then you pass it on to them, and then they'll get a hold of it. And they begin to praising God. Glory to God. The Bible says his ankle bones and his leg bones gained strength just by hearing the name of Jesus. Because Jesus was inside of Peter and James. They didn't mind telling them about it. You all might remember also in that first chapter of Acts when Jesus told his disciples that you shall receive power. Good God Almighty. Once the Holy Ghost come upon you, you will have power to witness, to talk about me, to tell somebody about me. I'm here to tell you, there have been many a time and many opportunities that have been given to Christians. They won't say a word. God put that Holy Ghost on the inside of you so you can be a mouthpiece for him. Has God ever done anything for anybody in here? Did you tell somebody about it? Guess what? He's going to do some more. And he loved to be bragged on. I can't brag on myself. I know it's almost football season. People are already bragging on their football team. We got some Steeler fans. Did I say something wrong? My son said, uh-oh, he said nothing wrong. Hey, that's one name I ain't calling out. I don't care what y'all say. I told him, man, the last 3-4 years, I said, "You look here, you give me $10, I'll take that hex off the cowboy." I ain't got no money yet. We brag on everything. But with the Holy Ghost, you got to learn how to brag on Jesus. Yeah. When you get on the telephone, the hemophone, what? Telephone? Both of them, anyway. When you get on that phone, and I guarantee you, somebody going to talk some junk about somebody else. Don't put your phone down. Remind them about Jesus. You see how quick they'll hang up. The devil love company. But when you talk about Jesus, they'll leave you alone. Good God Almighty. Some folk talk so much, they talk about the family, they talk about this, they talk about that. They talk about the neighbors, they talk about all kind of stuff. But rarely do they talk about Jesus. I'm going to talk about it because I've been standing here for 65 years. I'm going to talk about it because when I was 7 years old, a doctor wanted to cut off my left leg. Y'all see it? I'm going to talk about it because I've been diagnosed with sarcoidosis since 1989. And somebody say, Bernie Mac died from it. I'm still standing. None of them in the jail. I'm going to talk regardless of your age. Why don't you look at your neighbor and tell them something about the Lord? One more example. Just one more quickie. John chapter 4. There was a lady, a Samaritan lady. Y'all know about it. Jesus had come into town. While he was there, sitting at Jacob's tomb. Sitting at the well, just sitting. And he had told his disciples, I need to go through Samaria. Now, if some of you don't know, Samaria used to be the capital of Israel. But they messed up. They started going with everybody, leaving the Lord. Going out and finding them, y'all excuse the expression, but a hoochie mama. Anything that would get them away from God. I ain't gonna leave y'all men out, sugar daddies. I like to see y'all smile. Glory to God. Them sugar daddies giving each other high fives over in the corner. Hallelujah. And that's the reason why they were written off. The Jews didn't want to have nothing to do with them no more. They cursed them. But Jesus said, I have need to go through Samaria. He went there for a purpose. His purpose was to share and pass on the Holy Spirit or the Holy Ghost on to the Samaritans. You see, somebody else might write you off, but God never writes you off. He said he'll never leave you, nor will he forsake you. He's gonna always be by your side. Glory to God. Even though the Jews had written them off, and she didn't know what to say when Jesus came up there. But she said, why are you, who's a Jew, asking a Samaritan to give you some water? Jesus said, if you knew who I was, you'd ask me to give you some, check this out, living water. I'm not talking about that physical kind of water, because if you drank that physical water, you're going to thirst again. But the water that I'm going to give you is going to spring up into you. Living water all over your body, and you'll never thirst again. You won't have no need for nothing again, because I'm going to take care of you. Everything you need, I got it. And I'm going to make sure that you get it. Good God Almighty. The lady didn't know what to say. But she began to talk some more. And Jesus let her know who he was. All through the conversation. But this is the part I like. Good God Almighty. He said, you might worship over here. You might worship over there. You might be from St. John, or you might be from Mount Nebo. You might be from any of the other choirs that are here. But he said these words, Those who worship me must do so with spirit and truth. The spirit represents life. God gave you life through his spirit. You are alive and well. I don't care if you're feeling down. You might as well look up. Jesus will turn you around. Set your feet on solid ground. I was talking about Jesus and his spirit on the inside. Good God Almighty. And he said not only worship him in spirit, but you have to learn to worship him in truth. The truth means for certain. Whatever God said he's going to do, he's able to do it. You might have been waiting and waiting and waiting, but don't give up. God's going to come. He's on the way right now. He may not come when you want him to come, but I guarantee you he's going to be on time. Because he is an on time God. He is a God that will come right at the right time and do the right thing for you. Good God Almighty. Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit. Fall fresh on us. Fall fresh on every pew. Fall fresh on every person that's sick. Fall fresh on those, dear Lord, who need a financial blessing. Fall fresh on us, Lord. We didn't come here just to come, but we came to meet you here in your Holy Spirit. So tonight I believe God is stirring up some gifts. Did you see him stirring it right now? He's stirring up something on the inside of you so that you can be prepared to go on further. The end is not here yet. God still got a lot of work he wants us to do. People talk about unsafe neighborhoods. You better start praying. Anybody believe in prayer?
Yes.
Prayer still works.
Yes. Thank you, God.
Mama, that child that is acting a fool, prayer still works. I had two other brothers. I have two other brothers. We all went to church together. Mama made us go. But one, you know, it's always one. That boy got in trouble, looked like every week. Stayed in trouble. Sit in the same church. Heard the same sermon. Baptized in the same pool. Just couldn't get it right. You know, like on that movie, you know, can't get right. Like, yeah, okay. Looked like he just couldn't get it right. This boy spent a lot of time in jail. He drank plenty of alcohol. I'm talking to somebody right now. Because I'm sure my family isn't the only one. Huh? I'm glad drugs was not, you know, the thing back then, because they would have hit that too. One night the phone rung. I know my mama was a praying mama. Because when the phone rung, it woke us up about 3 o'clock in the morning. And it said that my brother was in a car that had been hit by a train. Y'all with me? That's not all. It was a woman in the car with him who belonged to some other man. Y'all still with me? but God is good.
Amen.
The car looked like that, but the train hit it. My brother came out with some scratches, 4 or 5 crack ribs, and when the train hit, it knocked him and the woman who was driving left. She didn't get hurt that bad. I said a train pushed him down the track. I'm so glad I had a praying mama. Anybody else sitting here praying mama? Mothers, keep praying. Your prayers will keep your children. Anyway, my brother now is serving the Lord. Can't get him out of church. He goes to church 7 days a week. He's singing in a quartet, managing another one. Every time I call him, he tells me I got to go to a Bible study. You know, some people say this, and I'm not talking about nobody, but they say the only way you can tell you got the Holy Ghost is you got to speak in tongues. Now, I'm like Paul. I do speak in tongues, but I pray in tongues. Because there are sometimes I don't know what to pray for, but God knows. I'm gonna say this and I'm finished. Some months back, our church went to see the prayer room. Or whatever the name is. Y'all know what I'm talking about. I'm getting old, bro. You ain't got that now. But anyway. We came back and I heard all this rumbling and carrying on in the house. My wife is in the closet, taking all the clothes out. I thought she was gonna, you know, give them the goodwill or something. No, she went there taking them out. Putting everybody's picture up there. Put the prayer requests all in the room. But guess what? I'll say this to the men. She don't spend much time in there now. Because God put me in there. Somebody in here. And when you pray, you need to pray for results. Because God gives you results through the power of the Holy Spirit. When the Spirit gets in you, your out becomes a mouthpiece that goes directly to God. You have a land that goes directly to God. I believe sometimes we can be praying and have the Holy Spirit in us. I know they say God hear all prayer, but I believe sometimes they say, hold on a minute, that's my servant Terry right there. He got a request. And you can put your name in there too. When you got the Holy Spirit in you, and you start praying, you will know those prayers are going to be answered. It might not be today. It might not be tomorrow. But they're going to be answered. Because God hears your prayer. He gave you that tongue not to talk about nobody. He gave you that tongue to pray for somebody. He gave you that tongue to tell somebody I love you. He gave that tongue to you to encourage somebody.
Thank you, God, Lord.
The Holy Spirit. The Holy Ghost. Is he in you? If he's in you, why don't you raise your hand? If you know he's in you. Steal from in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Glory to God. That trouble you had when you left home is gone right now. When you go around, you're going to see. It wasn't because I said it, but because you were obedient to the word of God, it's gone right now. You go back with peace in your heart. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Just let it move around the room. Spirit of the living God, move in this room right now. Move in this room right now. You're the author of all time and eternity. We trust you. We believe in you. Glory to God. We're standing on your word right now. If it had not been for you, we wouldn't be here today.
Hallelujah, Lord, I thank you.
Have our way, Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
In our lives.
Thank you, God, Lord, I thank you.
Thank you, Jesus. Yes, 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 yes. Yes, 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 yes. Ask him to forgive you. I don't know who you are. You know who you are. God said, just ask him. He's forgiving you right now. He's restoring you back to where you're supposed to be. Somebody need to shout hallelujah up in this place tonight. Thank you, Jesus. Bless the Lord. Thank you, Father. Somebody went on an interview today. They're going to be calling you soon. You got a job. And hey, they're not the only one. There's some old jobs up in here. He just say, when you work, you be a witness for me. Look like you can't get no job. You got it now. Say, thank you, Jesus. Thank him right now. Let's give God a hand clap of praise in this house.
Oh, bless the Lord. We thank God for this rich word. Amen. This authentic word straight from the heart. Thank God for Pastor Sire and his church family. Yes. Come on, say it again. Oh, I love Jesus. For those of you who can stand, we thank God for the Holy Spirit tonight that led us into this ministry, into this art of worship. I want to salute our brother and our new friend and church family. We thank you so much for coming. Amen. I want to thank all of the choirs who took the time to come tonight. Come on, let's give each other a round of applause. I believe that God's word wasn't set out, amen, for just zero. But let us learn to exercise our faith, amen, and receive what God has for us. Amen? Turn to somebody and tell them it was good to be in the house of the Lord. It's good to be in the house of the Lord. Come on, say it like you mean it. You may not see somebody tomorrow. To be in the house of the Lord. Tell him he's still passing out blessings. Do you believe that? He's still passing out blessings. He's still passing out blessings. Amen. logistics, and we want you to know that we're going to tarry here for about another 15 minutes with a few of our deacons and ministers. And if we have anyone who wants to be baptized tonight, amen, this is your night. We will stay here with you. The pool is ready. The Lord's Supper is ready. And we will lead you, amen, to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Amen. Amen. Once again, we want to thank our musicians. You all have done so wonderful tonight. Working together, the spirit of unity. Amen. Amen. All right, Brother Barry, you're going to come on back and give us our benediction in the last words. Amen. Any announcements before we leave from various churches? Any announcements? Any announcements from any of the churches? Yes. Amen. All right. Amen. Amen. And St. John is going to close out our inspirational time Sunday morning at 11 o'clock. Sermon and song, altar call, just calling on the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Thank you for inviting us. Before we go, don't you look at your name and give me a smile. We don't want anybody to be depressed. Amen. Can we join hands? I need you to survive.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Now, verse 2. The Spirit of the Lord in you. Serve for glad. May He turn things around for you and keep them around as you keep Him in mind.